Nederlandse overheid heeft forse veranderingen doorgevoerd in de zorg- en welzijnssector. We moeten van een verzorgingsstaat naar een participatiesamenleving. Daarom is Transo Tilburg University, de academische werkplaats sociaal werk, een meerjarig onderzoeksprogramma gestart met als centrale vraagstelling: hoe kan sociaal werk burgers versterken en verbinden met de samenleving?
The paradigm of empowerment is the central framework we use in our studies. Empowerment is a process or a mechanism by which people, communities and organizations gain mastery over their affairs. This means that we do not only focus on vulnerable people, but also on the communities they live in and organizations involved. And we call this the multi-level approach. This means that our central research question is how can social work strengthen vulnerable citizens and connect and reconnect them with their environment and society. In our studies, we strive for a multi-actor perspective, which means we conduct our studies as much as possible in collaboration with the target group, professionals, policy and science. For example, in my study on underpinning the girls' work method, I collaborate with 8 different youth work providers in the Netherlands. I collaborated with professionals and managers to conduct the research questions, to formulate research questions, the data collection, the research methods, and the validation of the results. And we used a target group to make sure that the research methods were appropriate to them. Our first aim is the scientification of social work. We use theoretical frameworks in our studies. This increases the credibility and accountability of social work. For example, in my study, I used the theoretical frameworks of agency and empowerment to underpin the girls' work method. With this, we explain what the aim of girls' work entails, and we give insights in the underlying mechanisms of the girls' work method.
The second aim of our collaborative center for social work is professionalization. As the meaning of work has changed the last decades for all professions, this also accounts for social professionals. As the support for vulnerable citizens has changed from aid to support, to empowerment, also the meaning of work has changed from being interested in fixing problems to coaching vulnerable citizens to empowerment and self-determination. This makes the profession more challenging, but also more vulnerable, as the social worker is expected to maintain a high working standard. So empowerment of the social professional is even more important, and our research contributes to this.
An important aim for our academic center is humanization of social work. This means that we don't only want to develop knowledge, we also want to contribute to the lives of vulnerable people we reach.
The fourth aim of our collaborative center for social work is appropriate research design. Questions can be raised if traditional linear research designs are well fitted for use in social work research. A more modern approach is merging knowledge, in which scientific knowledge, professional knowledge and experiential knowledge are mixed. Central is our questions derived from practice, which can help to support, improve and transform social work.
Ik heb voor deze onderzoeksbenadering gekozen omdat mijn hoofddoel echt is te komen tot verbetering. Vaak gaat onderzoek over wetenschappelijke kennisopbouw. Maar ik heb echt de ambitie om te komen tot praktijkverbetering. Daarvoor is belangrijk de participatie van stakeholders. En dat zijn diverse stakeholders, professionals, beleidsmakers, maar zeker ook burgers met ervaringskennis zelf. En wil je komen tot de verbetering, denk ik dat je tussen hen de interactie, de dialoog op gang moet brengen. Zodat we weten wat relevant is en wat ook mogelijk is om te verbeteren. Dus dat je dat commitment met elkaar draagt en ook samen daarvoor gaat. Ik ervaar het proces tot nog toe. Ja, het eerste wat in me opkomt is eigenlijk de slogan wel. Van alleen ga je sneller, maar samen kom je verder. Het is heel leuk, heel uitdagend. Bijzonder ook om te werken met een gemengd onderzoeksteam. Hè, met en die professionals en die burgers. Het is eigenlijk, ik zie het als een reis die we samen ondergaan, zonder nog precies te weten wat de eindbestemming is. Dus het brengt heel veel, maar het brengt ook zeker ook uitdagingen. Het kost bijvoorbeeld heel veel tijd, hè? Van, het kost meer tijd dan dat je het alleen zou doen. En het roept ook allerlei kwesties, dilemma's, vragen op. Waar je wel tussentijds mee moet dealen. Juist omdat je samenwerkt en eigenlijk vooral ook die gelijkwaardigheid in die samenwerking centraal wil stellen.
The method I use is Exemplarian Action Research. For me, this is a very empowering method. It's a research learning process, and the participants in the research formulate the themes on which they want improvement for their practice or their lives. From this formulating of themes, they make an action plan and they execute it themselves. And the researcher has the role of a facilitator. He or she describes the process and makes it transferable.
In my research project, I start with a structured literature review. As all research is embedded in the greater scientific global family, it is important that your research is building upon previous research. This research is accessible by different databases, but the abundance of information is the main pitfall, and the challenge is to select the relevant papers. Transo makes this circle round by asking their PhD researchers to attribute to this ocean of research. Well, I am investigating the growth of the social professionals and their clients and the relations between these two types of growth. My hypothesis is that there is a reciprocal relation between those two phenomena. Therefore, I'm using the self-determination theory, which defines growth as the accumulation of autonomy, relatedness, and competence, also known as the basic psychological needs. But it is good to realize it's a science, so we can never be sure of the positive outcomes.
An example of a research project is the Girls Work method. Girls Work has a long tradition. It exists over more than 100 years, but there is no research-based substantiation available. And therefore, three problems emerges. First, funding is linked to the outcomes, and there are no outcomes available of Girls Work. Therefore, funders threaten to cut back on Girls Work, and in some municipalities, this even caused for Girls Work to disappear entirely. Second, youth workers have difficulty substantiating the results to other professionals, other youth workers and managers, and therefore they did not acknowledge the importance of working gender specific. And third, youth workers had to find out for themselves how to act with girls, and therefore they could not rely on existing knowledge. Therefore, our research project is to substantiate the research method, or in other words, to prove and to improve the Girls Work method.